Hello guys. Welcome to a new video. This video is about the mystery behind a movie from 2021 called Army of Thieves. Grab your popcorn and let's go. Subscribe people, subscribe. Spoilers ahead. Sebastian is a German YouTube creator. He tells a story about a building in Munich that belonged to a respected locksmith named Hans Wagner. He was a hard-working man until his wife and son tragically died, whereupon he began work on the greatest piece of art. He made 4 safes. Legend has it that if you try to force open the locks, the contents will be incinerated. Hans built another safe and locked himself in it. People tried to liberate Hans he lets from his self-made tomb, but his work was ingenious. The safe that Hans died in served as his tomb and was sunk into the sea with his body still inside. 3 of his 4 safes, the Rheingold, the Valkyrie, and the Siegfried, are said to be still in use, although their whereabouts are unknown. Nobody knows what happened to the 4th vault, the Götterdämmerung. He concludes his video by asking viewers to hit the like and subscribe buttons. While the video is being posted, he solves an 8-second lock on his table and is pleased with himself. The YouTube algorithm is one thing he can't seem to figure out. Sebastian then returns to his mundane existence, grabbing a coffee and a muffin, opening the bank, and getting ready for work. His typical day consists of older people yelling at him. As he tries to divert his attention away from the lady in front of him, an interesting TV show comes on. He hands her the check, and she walks away. On his lunch break, Sebastian checks his channel. He has received his first comment and watch, and he is overjoyed. He is told in the comments to come to a certain location if he wants to put his skills to the test. He arrives at the spot in the evening. He gives the big tough guy a password provided in the comments and is allowed in. Sebastian is the last person to take part in the safe cracking. He is still perplexed and attempts to consult a close competitor, but he just ignores him. The host instructs everyone to begin, and everyone except him begins cracking the safe. The MC reminds them that just 4 people will advance to the following round. He then starts and manages to finish in 4th place. 4 contenders are still alive for the semi-finals. The spectators place their wagers and begin breaking open the safe. Neo is the first to open the safe, followed by Sebastian. They have 3 minutes in the final to burst open the door. Neo is certain of his ability. When the host says to begin, Neo does so, but Sebastian takes his time. He looks at Neo and places his palm on the door, as if detecting the mechanisms behind it. He makes small chat with Neo, and with 1 minute remaining, he is yet to begin. He starts and opens the safe with less than a second to spare in the last 30 seconds. Neo tries to leap over him, but big tough guy stops him. The audience applauds, and he recognizes a woman among them all, Gwendolyn. Sebastian's life will be changed by her. He would eventually learn numerous things about her, such as how she stole her first watch when she was 6, how her heart was destroyed when she was 16, how she stole her first car, and how she received a red notice from Interpol when she was 17. But, right now, in the basement, he has no idea. Later, at home, he displays his prize with family photos. He's obviously pleased that he was given the opportunity to demonstrate his abilities. When he goes to grab his coffee in the morning, he is startled by Gwendolyn and spills it on himself. She tells him that she was his first commentator and video viewer. He inquires as to her identity. Gwendolyn responds that she is the one who will permanently transform his life. She has been observing him and his behaviors, and she is aware that he is constantly alone. She begins to inform him that she has just been at the cafe for 7 minutes and that she has already stolen a woman's ring, someone's watch, and the man in the back corner. His weapon. She just comes out and says it. She's an internationally wanted jewelry thief and she wants to recruit Sebastian. She tells him that no one knows more about Hans Wagner than he does and that's why they need him. Because of the outbreak in America, in the next 96 hours the safes will be decommissioned in Geneva. This is his chance to solve the 3 puzzle safes Hans made. Gwendolyn grabs his hand and gives him an address to go to if he decides to join them. He continues his ordinary, boring life, and at home, while watching news about America's situation, decides to do it. Sebastian visits the address and Gwen greets him. Inside, he meets Karina, who is in charge of logistics and is a master hacker. Getaway driver, Rolf. There's no one faster than him, even Nicolas Cage would have trouble keeping up. The last one is their real-life action hero Brad Cage. He grew up watching a lot of Nicolas Cage movies. That's the entire team. Karina tells Sebastian about their strategy. The Rheingold is located in Paris, France, and has 413 million combinations. The Valkyrie is located in Prague, Czech Republic, and has 235 billion combinations. The Siegfried is located in St. Moritz, Switzerland, and has 72 trillion combinations and is estimated to hold up to $100 million. Bly Tanaka, the infamous millionaire, owns all of the vaults. They have no time to spend, so they travel to Paris, where Sebastian gets cold feet just as they are about to enter a credit union. They go over the plan, and Sebastian walks in first, straight to the bathroom. Gwen follows him, takes the guard's key, and requests a safety deposit box in his guise. Karina will walk in, and the cashier will be the only one who can assist her because no one else speaks English. Gwen slips out and picks up Sebastian before they descend into the vault. Everything went according to plan, and they found themselves in the vault chamber. The vault is known as the Rheingold. He wastes a lot of time before starting by giving Gwen the story behind the safe. She is uninterested and simply wants him to begin, but he continues with the story of how the gold for the safe was gotten and begins calling it his love. He plays the tune Das Rheingold. All the locks fall into position, and the vault is unlocked, thanks to the whirring and cranking of some mechanism inside. Sebastian and Gwen are ecstatic. It's not about the money, she says, but about becoming legends. He almost kisses her but decides against it. Then Sebastian goes out, and Gwen follows, completing their first heist. Interpol agent Delacroix has learned about the team's recent heist. Beatrix questions why this is relevant right now, when America is facing a zombie apocalypse. Surveillance cameras captured the offenders, and Interpol knows they are on the hunt for all of the vaults, with just two chances left to apprehend them. The crew is currently engaged in a game of beer pong. Brad asserts his authority with a perfectly legal throw behind his back. Over sandwiches, Sebastian befriends Rolf and chats with Karina, who wants to make out with him but his gaze is fixed on Gwen. Karina informs him that Brad and Gwen are dating, but that their relationship is not going well right now. Sebastian then pays Gwen a visit in her room, where she explains Brad's name to him. If Brad Pitt and Nick Cage had a child, the child would be named Brad Cage. He's just an egotistical person. Sebastian tells her about his boyhood dream of having a fancy name like Ludwig Dieter. They converse for hours about themselves, with Gwen doing the majority of the talking and Sebastian just admiring her. Meanwhile, Brad is enraged that his girlfriend is preoccupied with that rat. Gwen begs him to sit next to her and tells him that when they finish their mission, she'd like to go to America, Nevada, because the Götterdämmerung, the fourth vault, is said to be there. The following day, the crew heads to Prague. Delacroix is waiting for them there. Brad is not fond of Sebastian. They've arrived at their next bank, and the group is serious about doing business. Sebastian is terrified but certain that he can open Hans' safe. Sebastian disguises himself as an accountant and declares that he is inside. Karina's hacking has made his false ID scan positive. Karina leads him around the corridors till she has to break off the communication. Unsure of what to do next, he enters a room he shouldn't have. The guards notice over the cameras that he just disappeared. He meets up with Gwen in the elevator and they descend to the vault room. As the doors open, they are greeted by two guards. With a few Jackie Chan moves, Gwen beats them both up with no problem. And so Sebastian begins his work on the Valkyrie. He once again tells a story about mythology surrounding it. The Interpol still haven't spotted the crew and Delacroix gets antsy and figures out they're probably already inside. When the guards figure out someone is in their system and lock all the doors, Karina realizes they are onto them. Time for Plan B. The Interpol comes into the building and it turns out they are in the wrong bank. They change their safe deposit box to a more reputed bank. Brad enters the room while wearing a mask and shoots a couple guards with tranquilizer darts, knocking them out while beating up the others. He initiates Plan B, the robbery. Sebastian finally begins to laugh. His attempt fails, and the safe handles pull back, leaving only one handle pushed out. If he makes another mistake, the safe is permanently locked. He's experiencing difficulties, but he's making progress. Then another handle appears, followed by a third. He cracks the Valkyrie and unlocks all of its wealth. They applaud and embrace. They almost kiss, but Karina requests status through comms because they don't have much time. Gwen and Sebastian pack their belongings and go for the door. Brad is ready to leave when he is stopped by a security guard. He diverts his attention by jumping from a railing. He fights with the guard and is shot before jumping out the window. Despite the chaos, the couple manages to flee unseen. They attempt to get into the automobile as it begins to move. Brad assists Gwen, but when Sebastian takes his hand, he throws him out instead of drawing him in. Except for Brad, all of the members appear distressed. Sebastian is being pursued by the cops after attempting to steal a bike. He nevertheless manages to rob a random bystander. I'll save you the bicycle acrobatics for the time being. He escapes the cops by riding down a tiny path and boarding a moving train. Karina informs them in the van that Sebastian hasn't been apprehended yet, or that it hasn't been announced. The original intention was to let Sebastian go after the final theft, but Gwen is still unhappy that Brad abandoned him like a sacrificial goat. Rolf was even growing fond of him. Gwen is concerned about how they will handle Siegfried's absence, but Brad assures her that they have enough money to retire twice. It's not about the money for Gwen. Brad's last-ditch attempt to keep Gwen is to tell her he loves her, but she couldn't care less and gets out. Karina pursues her and determines how they will breach the next vault. Sebastian has made it home, where the girls are waiting for him, but he is unaware of their presence. After they discuss what to do, they decide to yell surprise, which Karina does, shocking him and causing him to spill his hot drink on himself. Gwen expresses her regret. That's all there is to it. He claims that whether he forgives her or not, they will go and he will return to his boring existence. Gwen gives him a long speech about how much she needs him, how he's the only one who can open the safe, and how they're going to make history. Sebastian takes a seat, takes a sip of whatever he's drinking, agrees, and inquires about the strategy. Meanwhile, the Interpol agent decides to do some YouTube research. He searches for Hans Wagner and discovers Sebastian's video, which instantly connects him to the thief. The video was uploaded 1 minute ago, and the remark was left 2 weeks ago. Sebastian fantasizes about zombies. When he awakens, they are on their way to St. Moritz, the location of their previous quest. Interpol agents are stationed in every corner of the last vault, which is housed in a casino. The vault will be moved in 2 hours. They decipher an encrypted communication from the team stating that they will attack the casino at 5 a.m. It sounds too good to be true, but they wait until 5 anyway and enter the casino. There, a manager tells them that they know about the risk and have already taken action. When he asks who told them, she says Interpol informed them and the safe was taken 1.5 hours ago. It really was too good to be true. Delacroix has been played. 8 hours earlier. Karina calls the manager and tells her about the robberies and she reschedules the safe transfer. Gwen somehow managed to sneak into a car and stay hidden, then beat up the two guards and left them on the road. They made sure Interpol intercepted the fake-coded message. They retrieved the Siegfried from the casino and loaded it onto the truck. With Gwen and Sebastian disguised as guards. In present time, on the road, after his usual warm-up, Sebastian puts on the music and begins to tell Gwen the story of the safe, talking to the safe at the same time. Meanwhile, the cops have left the casino, and Brad is enraged that his team has deceived him, which they did not, since they parted ways. He locates Gwen using Find My iPhone, and Karina discovers and tries to stop them, but they drive away and the cops apprehend her, but not before she sends Gwen her final message. Sebastian is on the 6th of 7 handles and is currently cracking the safe. He slaps on the safe and the gear kicks in place after a few rapid spins. He's successfully broken the Siegfried. Despite the fact that Brad and the cops are still on their heels. They open the safe, fill their bags, and Brad awaits them. From action hero to villain or just plain bad guy. When she and Brad dispute, Sebastian loses his cool and lunges at him, hitting him. Gwen ties them to the truck and escapes with Sebastian after that miserable spectacle. Brad and Rolf are apprehended by the police. Gwen appreciates Sebastian's attempt to advocate for her. He tells her he really likes her, and despite the horrible time, she ends up kissing him, and she really likes him too. They make their way to the boat with the money. Delacroix has finally caught up with them. So they've come to a halt, guns drawn. Gwen strikes a bargain with Delacroix, if he lets Sebastian free, he can take her, the agent agrees, but Sebastian does not. Gwen yells at him and promises him she will find him and they will solve the Götterdämmerung together. He finally gets on the boat and leaves. He is saddened when he checks his false passport under the name Ludwig Dieter and discovers that she has purchased a ticket to the same destination as she is. He wanted to be with her more than anyone else in the world. He had a feeling they'd rejoin and solve the Götterdämmerung. A while later, a woman and a man in California enter into a locksmith shop and discover Sebastian. They show him the Götterdämmerung blueprints and ask him if he can crack them. He laughs. If you enjoyed this movie recap, here are some more that you may like. Please hit the like button and share the video with your friends to help the channel grow. Thanks for watching Movie Shoot Recap.